Hi guys, so I'm going to tell you a story when I was only 18 and just came to Sweden, so I was learning Swedish. So he was a classmate of mine and I have been looking at him like months, just, you know, he was very charming, tall, dark and handsome, and yeah, I never approach him. To me, sometimes I need to talk, but that's it. But one day, he asked me, he said,
hello.
And I would say, like, let's just say his name was Christian, okay? And I said,
oh, hi, Christian.
Like, shy, because, you know, very handsome. And he had brown eyes and, you know, shirt, you know, very elegant looking and so charming and hypnotizing, so yeah. And said,
do you want to come with me to my house?
Like, and I was giggling. I was really like,
I'm Christian.
And he said,
so, shall we go home to my place?
And I was like, in my head, guys, there were so many voices like saying,
you naughty Anne, don't go over there. You know he's a player, you know he's a Casanova, don't go.
And some voices would say,
no, it looks okay, it's okay Anne, it's okay, don't, yeah, but maybe not today, don't come.
You know, everyone was whining, and so they were shouting almost and saying,
no, stop, don't do it.
And so I was preparing to say no, and he just looked into my eyes like really, you know. And I was preparing to say no when he looked into my eyes like that, and I just said,
okay, Christian, I'll go with you.
So we walked, and I remember it was not very hot, it was not very cold, so we were like just having t-shirts and jeans, and he had his shirt and flowers and things. I was like hoping, in my mind I was hoping like,
oh, please do something, kiss me, or yeah, you hug me. And
yeah, he didn't do it, guys. So he just talked about his family and he said,
in our family, we help each other and we live together, and nobody like has to be alone, and we have always each other to talk with.
Yeah, he talked like that. And I said,
that's wonderful, Christian.
In my head, I had lots of intelligent things to say, but that's the only thing I could come up with. Like,
oh, that's good. And yeah, and you're all here in Sweden?
And he said,
oh, yes, we are so many in our family, but we are all here in Sweden.
And so, but my body was like warning me. It was not just my head, it was just not only the voices, but like my body was like, ooh, like warning me. I could hear my heartbeat like really loud. I had even a tension headache, and so everything and everyone in my head was warning me, and they were saying, no, don't go inside the house, you know. And but we went in, and when we went in the living room, I could see two girls, like they had long hair, black, thick, a bit wavy hair, and to me it looked like they had belly dance costumes on them, but not dark, but you know, for casual costume, like they looked so sexy. I felt intimidated, and they were just sitting in the living room, and everything looked exotic, you know, Middle East style. And they had also, you know, cushions and pillows on the floor, but they also had, and carpets on the floor, you know, Persian carpets and things like that. So it felt so earthy to be in that house with them. And I had that thing in my head that they were his harem or something. And I was just waiting, and there was some soft music, like a belly dance music almost, but soft, you know, in the background. And I was like expecting them to belly dance for us, like entertain us or something. Of course they didn't, guys. And these two girls were not his harem, of course. They were not his girlfriends, of course. They were his sisters. And they were so kind, and they said,
oh, who's this?
And then he said,
oh, yes, this is Anne from school.
He said, so very cool.
Oh, hi, Anne.
I said,
oh, hello.
And
he said, oh, do you want something? Like, do you want to eat some food? Are you hungry?
And I said,
oh, no, don't bother. No, I'm fine.
And they didn't listen. They took like pears and apples and oranges, and I was just thinking, okay, they would wash them. And I am sensitive to apples and pears, but they didn't stop them. And I thought they were just going to wash them and give them to me, but they peeled everything like with their hands, of course, hands and knife and peeling knife. And I was thinking,
no, don't peel it off.
Because, yeah, I'm a bit, you know, clean freak. And I didn't want their hands. But they looked so clean, and they sliced everything, so like a salad. So it was a salad, but with their hands, you know, doing like this. And I was thinking,
I don't want to eat it at all.
And yeah, they did that. And I still eat them, so I was careful. I took mostly the oranges because I'm allergic to apples and pears. So I tried to eat, and I felt guilty for thinking they were his harem. So I ate what I could, and then they left. I don't know where they went.
Oh my god, now is the end. He's going to kill me. I don't know, cut me into pieces.
I don't know why I was thinking like that. I really felt guilty because even before I was going to his house, my mom saw us talking one day, and my mom said,
Oh, you should be careful with him because he seems like he's a playboy. So don't go with him. And is he your boyfriend?
And I said,
No, he's not my boyfriend. No, I'm not into him. Nothing. No, I'll go down to the basement, to my room.
You know. And so I didn't like tell her I was into him. No, nothing like that. So I felt guilty. And then when I met his family, then I was thinking, oh my god, why did I think that? There was nothing, no signal. So. And when we were talking, suddenly took my hand, and very sexy, and it was like,
oh,
in my head, like,
oh yes, he will kiss me now.
And suddenly he said,
you know, in Lipa. and I have a girlfriend.
I was like that. I said,
what?
I said,
yes. She's a virgin.
And I said,
what? Is she like waiting for you in Lebanon?
I said,
yes. We will marry in the future.
And I couldn't believe my ears. And I said,
oh.
I wanted to shout,
why the hell did you take me to your house?
I didn't, of course. And he said,
and since she's a virgin, I don't touch her. Because we are waiting for when we marry.
And I said,
you're not young, don't care.
I didn't say that, but I was thinking,
you son of a...
You know, I was really angry. And he said,
and I have a girl also.
He said, and I was like,
what is, why the hell is he telling me this?
And he said,
yeah, I have a girl who I'm very intimate with, so, you know, since I can't do that with my virgin girlfriend, I have an extra.
And oh my god, I was not wrong, guys. I was not wrong. I felt it in my heart, and in my mind, my god. And I said,
okay.
I was so insulted. Who was I then? Who was I? And he said,
my extra girlfriend is far away. And my virgin girlfriend, I talk with in the phone.
He said, and I said,
okay, Christian.
I was so embarrassed. And he took my hand, you know, caressed it again. I just wanted to slap him, guys. And he said that,
I want you to breathe. I want you to be my girlfriend here in Sweden.
And I was thinking,
that son of a moon.
I was really angry with him. And when he said that, I just lost all interest in him. So, I don't know. He complimented me on my eyes, that they were big and beautiful and things like that. But I just, it kept blurry and I don't know what happened, but I just lost interest in him. Like, totally no.
We'll never go out with you again. I don't care if you have a house full of belly dancers. I don't care.
It was just so funny that day that I realized he was not, you know. I realized I was not just imagining things. Even though I didn't know if he was a player, I didn't know. So, yeah. For some reason, people confess things to me, guys. Even when I don't ask them, they confess. I don't know why people do that, why they open up to me, and I have so many more stories I haven't told you before. So if you have like questions maybe or requests, maybe we have similar stories and I can dig into my memory bank and tell you. And if you have similar stories you want to tell us, you want to share with us, please write it in the comments below. And please remember to subscribe, like, and comment. Thank you so much for watching. I love you.